In this video, we will be demonstrating TecQuipment's continuous supersonic wind tunnel, the AF302, and the optional Schlieren apparatus. The wind tunnel itself is a suction-type continuous operation supersonic wind tunnel for investigations into subsonic and supersonic airflow around two-dimensional models for airspeeds up to Mach 1.8. For the layman, that's over 1,300 miles per hour. The Schlieren apparatus consists of lights and mirrors to show the pressure waves for visualisation of a supersonic airflow, i.e. a supersonic shockwave. Many engineers will work with airflow at supersonic speeds, so it's important for them to know the characteristic effects of supersonic flow around a range of shapes at different Mach numbers. Supersonic airspeed equipment is usually really expensive, so it's normally found at national engineering companies and institutions. This is a cost-effective laboratory-scale sized unit that creates results which can be easily scaled up to produce predictions of performance of much larger experiment models. Let's take a look around the continuous supersonic wind tunnel. The wind tunnel alone is 4 meters long and works by suction. A downstream suction from a powerful vacuum pump over here creates the upstream airflow into an inlet called the bell mouth with a contraction cone. It then passes into the working section. The working section is a precision engineered convergent divergent rectangle section nozzle with pressure tappings along the bottom. The bottom of the nozzle is flat and fixed, but there's a choice of three different shaped top pieces, i.e. subsonic, the Mach 1.4 and the Mach 1.8. You can see this glass window. We like to call it the portal. Models fit within the area between two glass portal windows that sit within a gear ring. Then slots in the glass windows hold the models in place. Down here is a small angle control knob that turns the gear ring that the glass sits within. This then turns the models mounted within it for changing the angle of attack. The models supplied include a 5-degree wedge, a 7-degree double wedge, 10-degree double wedge, plus a 10-degree double wedge with two pressure tappings. This is an angle encoder that is connected to VDAS, the Versatile Data Acquisition System. We'll talk more about that in a few moments. Below the working section is a bypass nozzle and duct connected to the bypass valve, which allows the user to control the amount of air that flows through the wind tunnel. Shutting the valve allows the air to be diverted to the working section for tests and to adjust the flow for supersonic speed tests. This is all mounted on a sturdy frame. The continuous supersonic wind tunnel is nothing without the instrumentation that connects all the data. Here is the instrument frame that sits on a bench or table and connects to the electrical supply to give power to any of the electrical instruments used in the wind tunnel. In the center here is a mimic of the pressure tappings along the working section. The tappings from the real working section over here connect to the mimic, then the pressure measurement instruments are also easily connected to the mimic. Over here, you can see a 32 pressure display unit that shows the readings from all the 32 different pressure tappings. Round the back is a connection to VDAS. VDAS consists of software that is freely available to download from the TecQuipment website and hardware that you can see here. It automatically logs and calculates data from experiments. Not only does this save you time and reduces errors, but it also puts the data in tables and charts the results. Finally, the data can be exported to allow further processing in other software such as Microsoft Excel. The vacuum pump fits inside a noise-reducing hood, and mounted next to it is a control box and remote control. I mentioned at the beginning that we would look at the optional Schlieren apparatus, the AF302a. This is what we have here on this bench. This uses refracted light and mirrors to show the pressure waves around the models in the working section of the wind tunnel. This is used with the optional camera that allows you to view real-life supersonic shockwaves as it occurs. TecQuipment offers two different supersonic wind tunnels, the continuous version that you can see here today with a powerful vacuum pump, and the intermittent version that uses a compressed air supply. For more information about the supersonic wind tunnels available from TecQuipment, click on the links in the description box below. Don't forget to subscribe to the TecQuipment YouTube channel and then click on the notification bell to ensure you don't miss any of our latest videos and live stream events. Thank you for watching.